The mark on his hand, was it a bow?
How do you know that?
Oh, no, 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 it can't be.
Hey, who is he? When's the last time you saw him?
When I cut off his head.
When I read Sleepy Hollow, the first thing I thought was...
This is one that I will gladly do for as many years as they want me to.
I was like, this is amazing.
I was like, let's go. I'm playing Detective Abby Mills, who lives in Sleepy Hollow. And just as she's about to change courses in life, something falls into her lap, which just happens to be Ichabod Crane from 1776.
Who is killed in battle with a guy who becomes the Headless Horseman, thanks to me, then wakes up suddenly 250 years later, and the world has completely changed. But the one thing that is the same is that there is still a Headless Horseman running around.
As you discover what's going on, it's not like you can tell people. I have the challenge of trying to deal with all of that in a town that really seems to be imploding, and that is Sleepy Hollow.
Put your hands on your...
You think he can hear us?
The relationship between Crane and Abby, at first, this sort of just disbelief, distrust.
Now, this is crazy.
Which makes it no less real. You just aren't yet willing to accept them.
Accept what? That the man I'm after is one of the four horsemen of the apocalypse.
And they had this really interesting rapport, being from different worlds and having different language.
Abby and Crane have to trust each other because no one else will believe their situation.
The show is different from others.
It feels like a summer blockbuster. It doesn't feel like it's a television show.
There's the modern day twist.
It's got the supernatural element, the buddy cop drama. It's a crime thriller. It can frighten people, get people thinking. You'll never know what to expect from the next week. Guaranteed.